Greetings, this is another video overview by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at the Nitecore EA81, which is an update to the Nitecore EA8, which is an 8x AA battery. Physically, the light looks very similar to the earlier EA8, I think Caveman that one was called. A few updates, of course, to the interface and the emitter. So, actually, let's start with that. You can see there, at the base of a reasonably large reflector, which is textured, is the new Cree XHP50. So this is a four-die emitter. You can see the structure there very clearly. This probably gets back to why we have the textured reflector to help smooth out any imperfections in the beam due to the multiple dies. There tends to be some slight distortions in the center of the beam, a darker center, for example. And so the textured reflector sometimes helps compensate for that, but I'll show you the beam in a moment. Physically, the light looks very much the same as before. Dual switch control, as with many Nitecore lights. The bottom switch is the on-off. The top switch is to change modes. Tail cap looks like before. If I open it back up, you'll see here very similar design from the Nitecore. You've got springs and slightly raised positive contacts, which match the battery configuration here. I just have regular end loop AA type batteries in here right now. I won't take them all out, but you can see it's double loaded, so there's two in each of these four wells. The orientation is kind of as you'd expect. Line up the pins and tighten the tail cap. As always, tension on the tail cap is what controls the contact. You can see it reads out the battery voltage when you first connect it, or at least the relative intensity of the battery. So if you unscrew the tail cap a few turns, the light will still work. So you really have to have this almost all the way off to really lock out the light. So that's not really something you can do on these types of lights, but that's standard on all these multi AA style lights. Interface is very straightforward. Simply click the power switch to turn the light on in the last memorized level. Click the upper mode switch to cycle through levels. So here's the lowest level, or ultra low, low, medium, high, turbo, and then back to ultra low. If you turn the light off in any given mode and turn it back on, you can see there it comes back on again, as you'd expect in the last level. So same kind of thing, you bring it back up, turn it back off. The one thing that's really kind of different now is this ultra low level. You can see it is very low. You can probably also see right there the artifact pattern of the beam. This is, of course, an extremely close-up kind of pattern. Maybe I'll sort of show it to you there. You can kind of see that there is this little sort of plus pattern in the center of the beam. That's what you would get for having the XHP50 type emitter. As you go up to further and further depths, it doesn't really matter, although you can still see a few minor artifacts. It's still a pretty good beam. In fact, I'll just show you the bring that up a few notches. Let's bring it right up to, turbo. So there you can see it's right off my desk. Bring it up to my standard, maybe that's about 3 feet or so. So you can see it's a fairly bright hotspot, but it does have a decent corona around the hotspot, slightly green tinted into the corona. Overall spill is fairly reasonably colored as well, maybe slightly pinkish or purplish as usual. Most of the greenish yellow tends to get it brought up into the corona of the hotspot. There are still a few artifacts in a slightly dark, hot center, slightly dark center in the hotspot. Again, that's kind of hard to get away with, to get around with these types of emitters. Although the texturing of the reflector probably does help a little bit. Anyway, but it is a way to get a very high output emitter in the AA class. Although clearly they went up for the 8x AA over the usual EA41 series in order to accommodate the higher output emitter. So again, very straightforward interface as you'd expect. A couple of things, I don't see a strobe mode on it. You do have the option to lock out the light by pressing and holding the two buttons simultaneously. And you see the light flash and locked itself out. Now it won't come on. You have to press both buttons simultaneously again, and now the light comes back on. So that's a way to lock out the light, given that you can't just lock it out at the tail cap. So it's a good feature to keep in mind. It should also lower the battery drain, which is also something that it can be an issue on some of these lights. But other than that, a very straightforward interface. One extra feature, if you press and hold the power switch to turn it off, you can see there's a blue light, which was giving you the battery readout when you first connected it. It now flashes in kind of a standby beacon mode to help you find the light in the dark. So that's kind of a feature that you'll have available to you as well. So turn the light back on, turn it off, it goes away. You have to actually recall the standby mode every time as you want it. So that's it. A very straightforward kind of light. You can see the packaging here. It gives you the detailed sort of specs again. 2150 lumens, you'll see my estimate in the full review. Distance specs as well, you'll see all my full numbers. If we open it up, you get sort of the standard Nitecore extras. Sort of a typical Velcro kind of pouch. Open at the bottom for the light. Extra O-rings, a basic wrist strap, and the manual, which, as usual, we'll walk you through the features of the light. As it points out, only standard AA batteries, alkaline nickel metal hydride rechargeable, or L91 primary lithium are acceptable. Rechargeable higher voltage batteries are not. They'll blow the circuit of the light. Again, there's the detailed specs, basic installation, basic operation, and the basic set of modes. There are actually strobe SOS modes. Sorry, I wasn't paying close enough attention there. Press the mode switch for more than 1 second, then enter strobe mode. All right, I thought I had tried that and it didn't do anything. Ah, there it is. So I guess I didn't press long enough. So there's your strobe mode. Single press gets you back out. When you're in the strobe mode, press and hold again. Yeah, advances you through the next one. So there's strobe, beacon, and an SOS mode. So there you go. And then, again, basic features of the light. So a basic package, but really just kind of an opportunity to get the updated high output in a AA format with the XHP50 emitter from Cree. Anyway, I hope you appreciated the overview. Please see my full review and my full review for more details. Thanks. For a full review of this flashlight, including beam shots, run times, and direct output measures, please see my full review, which you can access at Candle Power Forums in the review form under my username selfbuilt, or directly from my personal website at flashlightreviews.ca, which maintains a master list of all my reviews, as well as background information on how I do my testing, and links to recommendations for different types of flashlights in different battery categories. You can also click on my logo on the top right-hand corner to subscribe to my YouTube feed, which will notify you for every new review that I post. Simply mouse over to choose to subscribe, or depending on the type of device you're on, you can click and go to my YouTube homepage and then subscribe to my channel feed there. Thanks for your time. Hope you found this all useful.